good morning. Today we are going to do the lesson polar regions, and the topics to be covered in this lesson, we are going to learn about the climate of the people called Eskimos who live in their groups, what sort of groups they are, what the language they speak, the food they eat, the shelter they live in, and the dress they wear. Other than that, I would also give you little extra information. And not only this, we will also learn about the wildlife, like about the animals and the birds. And then finally, we will come down to the development of these polar regions and their connectivity to the entire or to the rest of the world. You know me very well, yes? Okay, fine. But still, for the new, some of them who don't know me, I'll just start off. I am Mrs. Prabha and I'm going to take classes for social studies. Fine. Now, before starting the lesson, look at the picture behind me. Can you see the picture? Can you identify with this picture? What is it? You can see a huge big ship. Yes, this name of the ship, can you see it's been highlighted? It is the Titanic ship. Can you recollect what exactly happened to this Titanic ship? Just go back if you know or something. I'll give you, to help you out, I'll give you another picture. Just see the picture. Here you have seen the picture sailing. Done? Now here you will see the picture. What happened to the ship? It's getting sunk. And do you know how it has broken into two? Now how can such a huge big ship break into two? It's not so easy to break. But then this huge ship, we'll show you another picture. What happened to it? It was being hit by an iceberg. You know the meaning of iceberg? It's a huge ice mountain. This iceberg, as the ship was moving, it hit an iceberg which hid itself under the water, and then water started and it broke into two, and that's how the ship got sunk. This is the story of a Titanic ship. Now let's come to the lesson. Now what are these icebergs? Where do you find them? Do you see icebergs everywhere? No, you don't see icebergs. To get an iceberg, the climate, what, how do you get an ice? When the temperature is very, very cold. That means you will find these icebergs in areas where the temperatures are very, very cold, almost frozen. Now, where do you find such places in our world? Now, look at this world map, okay? Now, in this world map, just see the world map. Can you find places where the climate is very cold? It's very difficult for us to find the places, which area is cold, which area is hot. It's not so easy. Now, leave the map to one side. Now, we'll take a globe. Take the globe. In this globe, you will find that there are two end points on the globe, which are called as poles. That means this is the North Pole and this is the South Pole. Now, why are we concentrating on the poles? Now, see, here you will have our sun. Yes, this sun's rays, when it fall on the globe or on our planet, you will see the sun's rays are not the same at all the places. When it goes down directly to the equator, this is your equator, the sun's rays are direct, so the temperature is very hot. But when it goes up, you will see the temperature, the sun's rays are slightly slanting. These are called temperate zone, where the climate is neither too hot nor too cold. That means the temperature is moderate. But now you will see the sun's rays are not sometimes touching the poles also. That means these areas near the poles do not get sunlight properly. That is the reason the area near the poles, or the climate in the areas near the poles, is very, very cold. Such areas are called polar regions. Now you understood? Yes. Now tell me, what is the degree of North Pole or South Pole? Just I'll give you half a minute or 10 seconds. Can you guess me? Tell me, what is the degree of the poles, North and South? It's your homework or assignment. You will find out the name of the person who touched the North Pole and have come back.